So last review I did was a Control Industries Carol Hacker review, which I love that kimono. I love the fit of it. It was awesome. But this time I'm actually doing the second to the last new, well, whatever. It's called a Rook. It's named after a chess piece. I've seen pictures of it in Jiu-Jitsu magazine. I've seen other Jiu-Jitsu players wearing it in videos. I've seen Tracy Goodell wear it. So we're gonna check it out. I got my hands on it, so we're gonna look at the stitching, we're gonna look at the general construction, we're gonna compare it to the Karahaka fit as well. The design on it to make sure, I mean, the one thing I do like about the Karahaka before was their design. It was really slick, smooth, it wasn't crazy garish like, I'm sorry, a lot of Jiu-Jitsu companies, man, they may have a little come with a tribal tattoo, you know, not that there's anything wrong with that. So we're gonna take a look at this thing. We're gonna look at the design, we're gonna talk about our likes, our dislikes, and all that business.
The game of chess is like a sword fight. You must think first, right? Before you move.
Style is immensely strong and immune to nearly any weapon. When it's properly used, it's almost invincible.
All right, here we go. Let's take a look at this thing. All right, I've go ahead and put the Karahaka on top of the Rook, so we can actually see a size comparison. You can tell that the Rook, the width of the arm, is just a bit wider right now, right off the bat. Again, this is just out of the package. It hasn't been washed or anything. So also, as a pan down, you'll be able to see that the Rook is actually a bit longer, too. I guess that's good for us tall dudes. It is an A2 tall. So yeah, take a look at that there. We're gonna get a better view of that here in a sec. There you go. Now you can actually see the difference here. As a pan in, you can see the width difference. Again, maybe once I wash it, it'll shrink up a bit. I really love the fit of the Karahaka because it's super snug on me. No one can grab me, but you know, so we'll take a look at that right now. So we can look at the Rook by Control Industries. As you can see from the background, we're not in my apartment in Brooklyn anymore. We are in Philadelphia, land of brotherly love. We can get choked out all the time. Well, actually, it's more of a shooting capital. We're gonna look at the general construction, the seam taping, the overall fit of this gi compared to the Karahaka, which is the one I reviewed back in 1954. So let's go look at this thing back here on the table, and then we're gonna go freaking roam this thing. And hopefully I won't get choked out. Okay, y'all know I'm gonna get choked out. That might not make it to the final edit because I don't think it's gonna go well for me.
All right, here goes some more details here on the Rook. I'm just pan up, take a look at the lapel. You can look at the stitching here, the contrast stitching. Usually with kimonos like this, with any of the darker kimonos, when it's contrast stitching, any insignificant, like, or shall I say, any kind of discrepancy with stitching usually really stands out. With white gis, you can actually kind of cover it, mask it, because it all just blends in. So here we go. We'll pan over and look at the hits there. That's pretty dope with the chess piece, the checkerboard there. And look at the stitching throughout the armpit here. It's pretty solid. Scroll through the chest, looks pretty good as well. We're just looking at any gaps, if there are any at all. And you can take a look at the ripstop collar here. It's an EvaFoam collar. Super thick, too. It's the EvaFoam collar is kind of common now on newer kimonos. It helps prevent bacteria and stuff like that. And we're just going to pan up and take a look at the chest stitching, which looks pretty rad right now. And here we go. You can look at more of the detail here. You know, you got the Brazilian flag and the Rook there. A big change from the Karahaka on those sleeves, on the shoulders. Another rad thing here is they actually have two types of seam tape. They got it on the inside, they got it on the outside. That gives you even more flair than you actually had on the Karahaka, which is pretty cool. And when you look inside, they actually have the chessboard seam tape there that says always three moves ahead. So if you roll in, like, people can actually see that, and that probably looks pretty dope. Now take a look at the lapel here, starting from the bottom down. You'll see how some of the stitching, again with the contrast stitching, it can be like you see how it may get a little crooked going throughout throughout the collar. What I've actually noticed since I've been reviewing geese and trying to make them myself is that for the most part, I've noticed like some inconsistencies with trying to stitch the lapel absolutely straight. And I know I've had a problem with it on my home machine, and I'm assuming these industrial machines you see here, like obviously the material must be so thick going through that EVA foam that it must be like virtually impossible to try to stitch it perfect. You remember that was my big problem with the Shoiro Compadre kimono review. I mean, they just went bananas trying to sew that thing right. But on this one, you know, you'll see here, it's relatively straight. There are a few little crooked stitches, but again, it is contrast stitching as well. We'll get a little closer. If you see any thick stitching in there as well, that's called back tacking. That's what we do when we sew a kimono or sew anything really just to seal the stitch. So it's not a mistake. That's just pretty much how it is when you sew. You got to seal the stitch. Otherwise, it's going to come unraveled. Take a look at the back. If you see any red dust on this, it's because the table was dusty. So I'm sorry about that, guys. Just looking for any gaps in the stitches. This looks pretty solid. And they also have the Always Three Moves Ahead seam tape on the bottom of the ripstop pan as well. So, you know, if anyone's trying to pass your guard or what have you, you know, maybe they'll be distracted by the cool chessboard thing and you can get out of that or something. Take a look at the pads. And you see as we pan up, you'll see the gray stretchy cord for the pants. Again, this one came with two, ripstop and the stretchy. I usually replace any pants I get with a clothesline because it's the toughest thing I found to keep my pants on and so they don't get pulled off. Because that's happened a few times in tournaments. You've seen in a few magazines, people's pants have come off because the cords weren't tight enough. It was a really cool hit of the embroidery here on the pant. And the back stitching. Just take a look at that. Again, sorry about the red dust, guys. It was dusty in that apartment. They got some really cool hits of gray on there just to add a little more flair to the kimono. And this is it on. Again, this is unwashed right now. You see the width of the arms on this kimono compared to the Kawahaka if you go look at that kimono review. And take a look at the pants. Again, I'm 6'2", about 184 pounds. And this is an A2 tall. Guys, that's it. I'm done with this review. I hope you found it super informative. I'm loving the kimono right now. I washed it. I got a little shrinkage in the length of the arm, the sleeve, so it actually shrunk down to match the Kawahaka, but the width did remain the same. Maybe after a few more washes, it'll shrink down a bit more. And I'm totally gonna wear this on the mat, and you take this information and run with it. Compare this kimono to other kimonos that you have, especially if we're around the same size, and I'm going to post up information so you can figure out where to get this jam. So anyway, all right, I'm out of here. I'll see you guys later.